Hi, my name is David Tu. I'm an application scientist with Keysight Technologies. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the new TrueVolt DMMs, specifically the 34465 and the 34470, to data log. And in this video, I'll set up the data log feature and then show you how to use the resulting data file to create timestamps on your PC. So let's go ahead and get started and set up data log. So first, I'm going to press this acquire button and then go from acquire continuous to data log. And once I go into that, I have a few options to set up. So for my sample interview, I want to measure once every 5 seconds. So let's set that up real quick. And then let's just measure everything for 1 minute. So 1 minute divided by 5 readings should be about 12 readings. And then the other thing I want to do is I'm going to log to my internal memory. You have the option of logging to your internal memory or to a USB stick that you can plug into the front panel. So now that I've got that set up, let's go ahead and run it. And it'll take readings for about a minute. So now that my minute is up, I'm going to save readings. And one of the things that is really critical here is I need to set my option to turn my metadata on. That's off by default, but I've got it on right now. So with that, that's going to provide some header information that I'm going to need for creating timestamps later. So I can change my file name, or I can change where I store the data, but I'm just going to let everything default, and I'm just going to save the readings. Now that I've done writing that file, I want to look at that file on my PC. What I have is my DMM is connected to my PC via a USB cable, and that allows me to access the internal memory of my DMM with easy file access, and it shows up on my PC like a normal thumb drive would. So on the PC now, I can see my DMM is here, and my data file is this data file called data1.csv. I'm just going to double-click that, open that up in Excel. And first off, you're going to see a few bits of header information that I mentioned earlier. So it's going to tell you the start date and the start time. And it's going to show you the sample interval. So here it is in the sample interval is 5 seconds. So in order to create timestamps, it's fairly simple to do. All I'm going to do is for that first reading, I'm going to set that equal to the start time. And for the second reading, I'm going to write a small little equation that goes equals time value, 0 hours, 0 minutes, and then the sample interval, which is going to be in B2. And I'm going to put dollar signs in front of those to make those a reference that's going to stay there versus move around when I drag and drop this later on. And then just add that to the value that's before that. So now you'll see that the timestamp value is 5 seconds after my first timestamp. So to finish that off, all I do is just drag that down. All the subsequent readings are 5 seconds afterwards. And now I've got timestamp values on all of my readings. So in data logging, it's important to know when you took your readings so you know when certain events happen. By adding timestamps and combining that with the data log function of our DMM, you have that data log capability. Hope that helps, and thanks for watching.